Nerderotic.com.
Norm Macdonald, people say, you know, they never tried to cancel him. He got fired from SNL. What was great this week was being able to just re-experience what an amazing person he was. And the fact that he didn't claim some sort of victimhood about his disease, he just sort of led a quiet life. And, you know, we heard about it. The good part is we got to revisit his work and, you know, comedy, good comedy is in such lack today. What Kyle Dunnigan and Kurt Metzger, though, what they're doing is better than anything on SNL today. SNL has just become unwatchable. It used to be like, well, there's 30, maybe 20 minutes of decent comedy in there, or something happened. Like when a Bill Burr was on, which was what, last season, he had that great opening monologue. But I mean, SNL has just become, it's just become completely unfunny. Then you look at what Kurt Metzger, Kyle Dunnigan are doing. That's what SNL used to do. That's what they had the balls to do. They don't have balls. They used to just go after whatever was funny. And it's just... Yeah. Just like with so many things in Hollywood, right? It's like, this is about fulfilling an agenda. It's not about being funny, right? The entertainment is secondary to what they're trying to push. And that is so obvious. I just was cringing watching SNL because I've been watching since I was a little kid. I'm older than Gary, by the way. I just need to let y'all know. That's why you can call me the ancient one. If you would like, I'm older than Gary.
There's not many that come on the show that I see. Gary's doing pretty good right now. Okay. Look at that smug face of his. Look at him.
You got that's not smug. You guys like, I'm old. Gary's old. Yeah. Thanks. Thanks for reminding me. I've only got a couple of decades left, everybody. Appreciate it.
It's sad. Scent of that show. It used to be culturally relevant. And now it's just like, They've targeted one group that is okay to make fun of, and you can't make fun of others, which is it's so obvious when you see it. Like, it's bizarre to me. It's just bizarre that we all can't laugh. This is what also I love about this show and all of you here, is that you all have a sense of humor about yourself. You have a sense of, I mean, look at those openers by Perry Chan are just, they're brilliant. They're absolutely amazing. But the fact that you all have a sense of humor, like that is, that's like a lesson for life, right? That's how you get through so much stuff. I mean, it's just like, I can't be friends with anybody that doesn't have a sense of humor about themselves, or even better, that can tell you to go fuck yourself when you need to hear that, right? Like, we've all been in places where we probably needed someone to tell us to go F ourselves. I can use language, right? Are we past a certain period where
you can abso-fucking-lutely
fucking
use
it? It's
not those N bombs from before when you started, okay? Just right. Those ones in play.
Yeah. But
that was
yeah.
mainly Ryan, though, to be fair. Yeah, it was only Ryan saying that. So
yes, I agree.
But yeah, Norm Macdonald, revisiting his stuff just really showed in contrast how comedy has fallen. The late night talk shows with those comedians, they're utterly worthless. There's not one of them that's funny.
It's been so bad, Chris. And like, you're 100% right that it's about both sides. Like, the last time I consistently watched SNL and thought it was fucking funny was like 2008. And in the lead up to the 2008 election, when they would do skits with Obama and McCain, it's like they couldn't take a shot at Obama. It's like they couldn't fucking do it. Whereas South Park was doing funny shit, making fun of both sides. And that was why that stayed relevant and stayed funny. And SNL fell off a complete hill. Like, that's where I first remember it happening.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, criticizing both sides of politics is always something that has been attractive to the majority of the audience. And, you know, when you treat someone or a group of people like they can't be joked on, that creates division and that creates problems. And that's where I remember it beginning. Ryan's right about that. Like, you couldn't joke about Obama. It was a total, and it's like, wait a minute, we've always joked about politicians, regardless as to what side they were on. And that's where it started to change. And then it just continued to get worse and worse. And now we're at a point where you just have to be so careful about what jokes you say. And that's why you're talking about Kyle Dunnigan and Kurt Metzger, and they're awesome. Chrissy comes on here, man. Holy shit. She says stuff. We're like, holy shit.
What?
We love it. We love it, though. That's just great.
Yeah, like, holy crap.
Humor's meant to do that, though. Humor's meant to be provocative. with Norm Macdonald, just the way that he just consistently went after O.J. Simpson was hilarious. And it's just like, you could just imagine if Norm wrote a joke after his death, it'd be something along the lines of, I was relieved to find out that I died of cancer and not that O.J. Simpson killed me.
Yep.
You know, I think it would be kind of like the epitome of an afterlife joke from Norm there. But yeah, I mean, when Chrissy comes on and she says some stuff and it's made us, you know, go, and if you're getting that shock factor, that's what you want from a joke. Mm-hmm. You want a joke that's going to shock you. You want a joke that crosses the line. Everything's fine. Everyone's fine. Nobody's been hurt because of these jokes.
Yeah, and it sucks having to explain humor, but I'm sure there's people talking about inconsistencies in speech, and free speech is free speech, and people can say what the fuck they want, and nobody really cares. But when it's humor, you know, I've had people email me going, oh my God, this joke by somebody, I don't want to put anybody on the spot. And my response was,
you can say Ryan, it's okay.
This joke by Ryan about somebody with palsy, and they were upset, right? They were respectful. So I wrote back, hey, just so you know, like, you know, Ryan's just trying to make you laugh. Like, that's not what it is. It doesn't come from this raging place of hate. We're here trying to make you laugh. We might go some places you're not like, and not every show's for everybody. And I totally understand that. And I respected what the guy, you know, was talking about. And the intent has a lot to do with a joke. You know, with Chrissy comes on, when Metzger comes on, and if Kyle Dunnigan comes on, I'd love for him to come on. They're just trying to make you laugh any way possible. And they'll do anything to do it, but it has nothing to do with what they're actually saying. There isn't an evil intent behind it or a disingenuous intent behind it. It's just comedy. That's the way it has to be. Can words harm people? I guess it depends on the person, really. It depends on the timing of the situation as well. We can't always make blanket judgments, kind of like if somebody's on the show and do we adopt all of their beliefs? Fuck no. This is about people talking to each other and just having fun. That's all it is.
Yep.
Oh, Saturday Night Live. See, the thing with comedy is, comedy has to be firmly grounded in counterculture. Otherwise, you're like a Vegas act or some, you know, fucking TV show, or you've already sold out and you're doing a sitcom. A stand-up has got to be counterculture. And if you're looked at as a sellout, you refuse to go certain places, you're just going to lose respect, Patton Oswalt.
Patton Oswalt, I loved him, man. Like, he was great. And he knew movies too. Like, he was a legit nerd. And I don't know, like, just lately, it's a weird thing that sort of captured, like, people in a certain space of celebrity. Mm-hmm. Feel like almost like, well, here are the guide rails now that I have to stick in. And in order to continue my career, I have to stick within these guide rails. No wavering from that. And that's what sucks, because there's so few people willing to just say F that, like Bill Burr or Rogan or whatever. It's just like, it's a short list of people now. I think we're going to look back on like art, whatever you want to call it, music, film, comedy, whatever, from this era. It's like, that was a really shitty era for culture. Like, the one we're currently in right now.
Yep.
Yeah.
Terrible era for it.
NerdErotic.com. Please subscribe.
If you like what I do here, please consider subscribing to the channel and liking and sharing the videos. It really does help. And if you did this with your favorite YouTuber as well, I'm sure they would appreciate it as much as I do.